make a big noise, playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place.
Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. Now you do what they told ya. Told ya. Told ya. Told ya. Told ya. Told ya.
So here we go. We're at home, and we just got Beadle and Grimm's Platinum Edition for Dragon Heist. This is the level 1-5 Waterdeep Adventure for D&D, and this is the first set that Matthew Lillard and his group of friends went out to put together to kind of expand on the experience of being a dungeon master and playing a an adventure. So this is the box. This is a big old box from the get-go. I wish I had a... this is a big old dice. That's a human hand. Just for comparison, this is huge and it's heavy. It's got shit going on all over. I paid for this myself. This is not something that they sent for review or anything. I just want to give people the experience of what you get and how you get it. And so that you might want to, you know, have an opinion for yourself. If you want to jump in to this the next time around that they go and do a Platinum Edition. Let's see, miniatures that came out. Boom, Tinkling Sorcerer. And these are from Nosur's Marvelous Miniatures. This is a troll, which, if you play Dragon Heist, you know that off the bat, you come into some of them. Aragonassi Genasi. Ooh, look at this. Nice. This is a centerpiece right here. Beholder. Beho ho ho buddies. Elf Ranger. Most of these, if you're not familiar with them, have two options most of the times. They're gonna be in different poses. Sometimes they do both genders, like one male, one female. Bugbears everywhere. The drow. You know, for a minute there, most of my life, I was used to calling them drow. And that may be because I come from a Spanish talking country. I meant to say Spanish. So it was drow, and then I don't know at what point in my life I heard somebody who was official calling them the drow. And it's been hard because most of the people I play with got accustomed to the incorrectly phonetical drow versus drow. This is a couple of mind flayers. Amazing monster. Nice sculpts all around. I already know some of these miniatures because I am a fan of this series of D&D creatures and monsters. So this is good. It's good to know they went with something that's solid and that it's already familiar with the setting. A little bit of a hard time because I'm doing this one-handed. All right, just a little bit of tape. This is the canvas map. Jesus Christ, it's huge. This is great. This is something else. This is the whole city of Waterdeep. From the bottoms of deep water up against all the wards. This can be put on the table, on the wall. Probably the players are going to want this so they can put notes for themselves and maybe like pinchers or something, a marker for stuff that they're interested in following up on. It's really good. The quality is, I mean, shit. This is being able to touch a map for your D&D campaign. So that's really good. And there's something else. Ooh, no spoilers, but this is a troll school manor. So your characters will be going to this place and probably will be returning throughout the five levels of the adventure. So this is good to have. This is cool. The map, feel, the canvas, and the art, I feel, also was colored a little bit different than what you get on the main book. Because I actually got this set, which has the D&D Beyond DLC, I guess, or the virtual product. I got this for Roll20 for the adventure, the module basically that has the maps, and I had already gotten the base book, the Dragon Heist book, which also has the maps, and I think I bought the there's a map set. But I don't remember if it's Dungeon of the Mad Mage and Ravnica, or if it's actually Dragon Heist and Ravnica. But it's good to have that map over there. We're about to get into the beefier stuff. And woo! Let me put this over here. What is this? Jesus Christ. All right, so, oh, I know what this probably is. Let's see. Ooh. What is this? It's a little bag of holding. And what does it hold? This is, oh man, this is cool. Probably what, or a fist? Hoo-ah. This is the symbol for the Centarum, the Harpers, all up in the shit. Harping. A dragon, basically. This is the name of the coin. That is a gold coin on D&D Forgotten Realms. And that's what they call it over on Waterdeep. A dragon. So Dragon Heist basically is about getting half a million of those coins from a secret stash. You get to it on the campaign. This is not a spoiler. This is basically the hook that gets you into it. This is a very particular item that goes into the game. So I'm not going to go too much into it. It's just the Rock of Galore. If you saw a stream of many eyes, you saw it running around and people getting into shenanigans trying to get it or lose it or whatever. There's another dragon over here, meaning another coin. Ooh. There's a signet ring. And what is this? The Lord's Alliance, maybe? Yeah, I think this is the... Well, I don't know what the ring is. I think this is the symbol, like a badge. For the Lord's Alliance, probably. That you may use, if you're a good person. This is for the Order of the Druids and Green People and Beagans or whatever. The Confederation of Kudaline Nature-Loving members of the Forgotten. Whoa, shit. It's okay. Oh, there's another coin. I got three coins. Dragon Heist! Try to get three dragons! Do a heist to do it! I guess. I'm going to put this in here because this box, you cannot feel it, but it's been slowly moving around because there's no more weight in there. It's a DM. Oh, here we go. Art is absolutely amazing. One of the things I loved and that we went over when we were doing the Dragon Heist, not really a unboxing, but we were talking about the book when it came out, and one of the things that I loved was the concept art and the art that actually made it into the book and the one that didn't. And this is absolutely the faction, the houses, conditions. If you're a DM and you're starting and you are not super familiar with all this stuff, obviously this helps out. But also specifically for Dragon Heist, you can see a lot of different things in there, and I don't want to spoil anybody, so I'm just kind of zooming through it. You got a quick name chart over here, a great thing. I know Dungeon Masters have sometimes like an app or a webpage where they go in and it's like, you meet Robert Stone Tree, or I don't know, Brian, and you're like, I don't know about Brian, but maybe Baern or Harvick or Althea or Carrie or something like that. That's pretty cool. A lot of establishments also to use. This is pretty cool. This is mostly the conditions. So voice cannot close it properly. There we go. The main art looks to be the three characters from, like, the child characters from Dice Camera Action that are looking upon the city. Great stuff. Let's go over here. Shit. I might have lost a little bit of sound there because I'm not accustomed to recording with my phone. I think the mic is over on this side where I had my hand, so... If it was a little bit low, my bad. My bad, boo. What is this? Oh, this is the art. Oh, I'll put you down for a second right here. Stay with me. Oh, shit. Well, I'll do it really quick. Oh, fuck. Okay, yeah. And, Jesus Christ, an escalator. Probably cut this for a second. And we're back. I was opening up a bunch of this stuff because it got really difficult with just one hand. I did not recommend trying to open the whole thing with one hand. Not the best look you're gonna get. Boom. This is art. I think this is gonna be mainly exclusive to the Platinum Edition, because all of these on the back have a scene description that's probably for the bonus encounters that are being released with these books. In the format for the Platinum Edition. So I think this may be exclusive to that. The art is pretty good. This is top notch. I think you can take it out as and put it down as just reaffirmation of the storytelling and the events that they're going through. I put all of those in this cool box that comes with the whole thing. I think you can put your dies, you can put everything that's like a physical, like a prop that you want to use for the game. So that's pretty neat. This is the appendix, the magic items, monsters, NPCs, basically the crunchy portion of it. It's comes as a booklet, a booklet on its own. Again, I don't want to spoil stuff if you're playing it or if you don't want to read it yet because you got it on your own. This is a great prop right here. This is the Enchiridion, which is basically an explanation of the city of Waterdeep through the eyes of Baltum Gadarm. This is in the book, and you can actually, I think you can get it on a PDF. I don't know if that's a thing, but I've seen it running around as such, and I was thinking that that'd be super awesome if you can print it out and just deliver it to the players, and here it is. So you can actually do it directly without going through the motions of getting all that done. And finally, the strong bits. What they did for this is cool. They broke it apart and they did like mini modules for the portions of the adventure. So if you've seen the adventure, you would know that this takes you from level 1 to level 5 in theory. It can take you upwards from there. And if there's additional scenes and stuff, you may end up in a higher place level-wise. This drives into Dungeon of the Man Mage, which is super cool because this is literally in the same place. So you can build your NPCs, you can build the city around your characters, around the adventure that they have from level 1 to 5. And then you can carry on to a higher level, more dungeon-y exploration and feistiness of going into the depths of one of the biggest dungeons in the Forgotten Realms, if not the biggest, the Under Mountain. First episode, second episode, it separates. This is the Trollsku Alley and chapter 3, the Fireball. Dragon Season, great art. This is all art from the book itself, but it uses it to great effect on this thing as the covers for all the sections. If you have not gone through the adventure, and this is your first view of it, I guess, you will find that there's some modularity to it where you can select different paths, and that takes you in a different way through the adventures, through the events, and through some of the locations and the NPCs. So it's good that it's broken down like that, because on the book itself, and I'm not saying that as a bad thing, but sometimes you need to go through a little map, like a logic map of what goes where and when, so you can go back and forth amongst these places. This makes it way easier, I would expect. And I will do a follow-up at one point, because I'm going to use this, because I want to test it out. I already ran Dragon Heist, but I did like a... was advanced players, they were very familiar with the system, so I didn't need to stop and take him like through every motion of the game. It did well, but I want to try it with all this shenanigans. I want to give myself a little bit more time so that they can really go into it. They can really mess with the locations, NPCs, you know, drive the familiarity with the scenes. And I think, you know what? I'm gonna put a little bit of a pause on this, and I'll come back with it open, because again, I'm getting into this one-handed unboxing difficulties. I'm not doing well, so I'll come back in a minute. And this is the big part. This is the final box where this goes in. This has the module, this has the icons, we got the maps, Troll School Manor, the map for Waterdeep, all the miniatures around here. There is an Adventurers League little thing in there that you can check in your Adventurers League play. Boom. This is the last stretch of this. So off the bat, I'm going to tell you, I just went through this because I was opening it. Oh shit, I didn't know this was here. Boom. What is this? Oh, okay. So this is the stat block for your Platinum Edition Beadle and Grim's Pandemonium Warehouse Swag Shop. You can get some of the stuff you saw in here on its own if you lose it, or if somebody just wants a piece of it, if you just want one of the icons, if you want additional coins, if you want to do some other stuff. Those coins were actually being given out on Stream of Many Eyes. I got a couple of them from that. They are amazing. They feel good and heavy on the hand. It's a great prop to have regardless. So some people might want some of this stuff on its own, or additionals, or maybe all the party is actually Rangers, or serve the Lord's Alliance. So you can go and do that over at Beadle and Grim, who actually drove the whole thing and created this product. And we just come back to finish off what's on the box. This box is thick, so you can actually put all your stuff from this and the minis once you got them ready, throw this in here. And I want you to see the value of props. This is the code legal. It is basically the bylaws that govern Waterdeep and the activities of the characters within. You have this as something that you can give out for them to read. You can post it in the wall of your gaming room so they have it available at any time. Same thing with letters, notes. I'm not going to show you the whole thing of these because some of them are actually story related. I obviously do not want to spoil you. Look at this damn thing. They went out of their way and they actually put out like a gazette or whatever it passes for, like a paper in Waterdeep, so that you can actually get this to your players. This is good. Same thing. I'm not going to go over it on detail because some of it might start making sense once you start playing, or if you're playing it. You get a bunch of these so you can pass them over, because the adventure is on it's on a timeline. So there's events going on regardless of if your characters are actually engaged in what's going on, or if they're going around or doing something else or taking a different path. So they can be aware that things are going on, and this can be a driver and a hook for your characters to jump in into whatever it is that's going on that might be a plot for a further chapter. This is another document, Deeds of Property. And these are the dual. You can put them in there on your Dungeon Master. What you call it? That thing right there. Jesus, the word just went away. But you can put it in there so they can see whatever you're describing, just to give it atmosphere, just for them to visualize some of the stuff happening. Spoilers. There's some kids with some noble people that you might get to meet later on. Apparatus of Qualish. If you haven't played the adventure of Qualish, go try it out. That's a lot of fun. Great art. Specific, if you've read Dragon Heist and you see this, you might see where this pertains to, and that's a good thing. It gives you a visual. It just it helps out the description for the Dungeon Master, and it gives everyone a visual of what's going on. This is the encounters. They're printed on a pretty, I mean, this is really good quality. This is what I would expect would actually be in a book or a booklet or one of the small adventures, like The Minds of Phandalver, would be similar in quality on the printout for this thing right here, which is all the additional scenes that you can put in to fill out a little bit more of the story, or to expand on some of the paths or some of the hooks that are put out in the adventures. Because Waterdeep is really an expansive setting as a city. It has all this stuff going on. It's going to New York. It's figuring out there's a lot of people and their factions fighting for power. So there's different things that your characters may be interested on that you can actually dig into without having to go all the way out and creating your own stuff. Obviously, that's also encouraged based on the understanding that you get from the module and from the breakdown of what's going on in the city. But it also helps that you can have just like an encounter that has a story, NPCs already built up. Just read on it and you're ready to go. So that is a good thing. These right here were a surprise. I was going through them right now. You can take this off, and these are actually Troll School Tavern. It's not Manor, it's a tavern. And then you do boom. And suddenly you got a shot. This is four of them that you have available. You can probably send them around the table, or you can just have it as a keychain. It's pretty cool. And use it in real life, if that is a thing, running around with a shot for any opportunity that comes up. There's modular maps in here. The cool thing about it is that these are designed to be put one atop another to simulate the interior of a building or the exterior site of it on the general map. There's a bunch of them. I'm not gonna open them because really, that should give you a very good impression of the type of maps that you get and the design style that they have, which is concurrent with the one used on the regular book. I got one last thing, which is this, but let me one hand style. Yeah. Oh shit. Nice. Price of the box right there. And then I can just tear and rub. Oh my goodness. There we go. Nice. Again. 1,000 upon these. Okay. Alright. So these are the last portion of the box. These are the monster that you can put on your dungeon master. Oh my goodness. Your dungeon master thing that covers from the observant eyes of the players. On the other side, you can see the stat block. This is a great thing because a lot of the times it's difficult to go back and forth if you're running an adventure and you got the stat block somewhere else. They already have a broken down appendix that gives you the stats, and I'm not gonna turn them all because some of them might have spoilers. If you're running the adventure, you're the devil. Yeah, son. Bugbears all around. The terror of my original players. A cavern crawler. This is really good art. I don't know if this is the one from 5th edition regular. I don't think so. But that looks pretty cool. You got characters, you got monsters. This is big. I mean, this is a human hand right here. So if you're gonna see this, you got a very, very good helping hand on people visualizing where they're fighting against. Stats on the back, and then you got descriptions on top. Everything you would need to run the monster is literally right here, which you can put in front of you. That's a beautiful Jarlaxle right there. If you don't know the character, that's a classic. That's an icon from Forgotten Realms. You got some other dudes right here that I'm not going to go into, but the art is absolutely beautiful. I don't know why this guy does not have a miniature, by the way. D&D, if you're looking into this, this needs a miniature. This is a pretty cool monster, and it is quite prevalent on the first portion of Dragon Heist, so it'd be a good thing to have something to throw in there if you're running miniatures. And that is it. This is Dragon Heist. I am very, very happy with this. I must say, I'm actually surprised about all the stuff and how they made it. I already had the book, so I know the content, but the way that they broke it apart, and it helps. And they made it for an experience where the DM is going to have a facilitated process to get to the information that they need, to have what they need on hand, and to diminish the prep time required, because this is already pre-done, basically. Waterdeep Dragon Heist is the first of Beadle and Grimm's series of Platinum Editions for adventures and adventure paths for Dungeons & Dragons. I love it. Well worth the money. This is basically a Cadillac experience for D&D, so it is hefty. The price is quite high. But once you see what you get, and if you put into effect the time and the effort that it would take for you to do the same thing yourself, it's a pretty good deal. I think it's worth it, and I love my copy of it, and I am ready to give it a ride. So thank you for being here. It took a while, almost half an hour, I guess. I think I may trim this thing into a single video and then put it up somewhere. And that is it. This is Mike Bias. Normally we play in Spanish D&D in twitch.tv El Guarius, which is a channel for D&D, I guess. And that is gonna be it for today. Thank you so much for stopping by and seeing this shenanigans, and enjoy your dragon heisting. Heist!
Alright, you are rolling.